What's up, guys? Me again, and welcome back to Watch Me Play Fallout 4. Last time, we insulted the Dream Tank Genetics, and we got the Quasar chip. And we also got decoded. So now, we have to head back to Virgil. And then return to Virgil, see what he needs to say. Alright, this time, it did not start me at in the actual laboratories. I'm at the entrance. Thank you. Hey, Virgil! I got it!
Hey.
Wasn't sure I'd see you again. Managed to get what you need?
Yep.
I have the code.
Suppose I shouldn't be surprised. You did get rid of Kellogg after all. Not too much of a leap to take down a courser. How'd you manage to get it decoded?
I've made some friends. Actually, doesn't really matter.
Does it matter?
No, you're right. It doesn't really. The point is that you got it. You're not the only one who's been busy. I did the best I could, from memory and things I've overheard through the years. Came up with some schematics for you. Wasn't easy. These hands are ridiculous. Fine motor skills have gone to shit. Here's the symbol explanation. You need to build a device that will hijack the signal the Institute uses to teleport coursers. And send you instead.
Nice.
You know the craziest part of the design? That classical music station. That's the carrier signal for the relay.
Oh, really?
All the data's on harmonic frequencies. You've been hearing it all along. I want to be clear that this isn't my area of expertise. I was bioscience, not engineering or advanced systems or anything.
Bioscience? Advanced systems?
Divisions within the Institute. Specialized groups working on various projects. It'll make sense later.
Really?
But if you can build this device and make use of that code, you should be able to override the signal from the Institute's relay. Can you? I mean, can you build it? You have people that can help. This is
so,
a lot
somewhere,
for one
somewhere.
Person, even you.
I got it covered.
Good. Good. Because you've got to make it in there. For both our sakes. And don't you forget our agreement. I've helped you as best I can. If you make it in there, you find that serum.
That's my
only hope for ever being normal. So you find it. Now go on. Take these and get to work.
Talk to the brother, or hell no. Talk to the Minutemen. Or talk to the railroad.
Okay,
well,
that's just about the worst thing I've ever smelled in my entire life.
Well, I can't. Well, I'm not the general of the Minutemen. I don't want to talk to the Brotherhood, so I'll have to talk to the railroad. Alright, hey, Dez.
Randolph Safe House has been MIA since Switchboard.
We won.
Now, we got one of the dead drops tagged. Dez wants you to check it out.
Checking out dead drops is your job.
Not when it could be a big old trap from the Institute. Once you take care of the dead drop, report in to Dez.
Well, I'm not gonna do that.
Desdemona.
Do you need something?
I have plans here to build a signal interceptor that can get me into the Institute.
So that's what the Corsair chip was all about. You needed that frequency, I take it. Why? What does this machine do?
What do you think it does? Teleportation.
The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out. The interceptor can hijack their signal and send me instead.
We've spent dozens of years and too many good agents' lives only to discover not a goddamn thing. And now we have the answer, thanks to you. Teleportation.
Yep.
The Institute could build something so... But we've got work to do. This is our top priority now. I want Tinker Tom to help you in any way possible to get this device built.
Tinker Tom's cooking up something. I hope it goes better than last.
Alright, Tom.
Ready to hand over the plans? This is the big one.
The big one? There you go.
Here you go. Let's see what we need.
Hold on. Who wrote this? Some kid with a crayon? Must have been a real big kid.
Oh, man! Molecular transmission via encrypted RF waves?
Naples Institute eggheads are crazy. And you can divert the signal using a heavily modified relay interception. Like a pirate broadcast, you know? That's intense.
Skip to the part where we build the thing, Tom.
The plans cover all the high-end egghead shit, but they're missing a ton of engineering detail. Filling in the gaps will take time. This bit here, the stabilized reflective platform, just needs some high-grade metal. Easy.
Really?
By the time you finish that, I'll have the rest done.
You better figure the rest out, Tom.
And I've done a whole lot more with a whole lot less, my friend.
We can scrounge up the platform components you need. No problem. But where to build it? It's gonna need some serious space. This baby's big. I heard you and Pam were cooking up a new safe house. Mercer, right?
Yeah.
You might want to move on that. It's got a workshop, a good location, and the full blessings of her predictive algorithms. Once you set up the safe house, we'll drop off the materials there. Or you could build your own platform somewhere else. I guess. Your call.
Might as well do it at Mercer, I guess. Tafferton Bowhouse. Oh, God. All right, I got to travel to Bedford Station and make my way to there. You know what's weird? When I revived this series, I started uploading after a couple months of not uploading. I said that I was going to, limit Fast Shadow only, but I don't know if I'm Fast Shadow. That's because I'm Fast Shadow between the Glowing Sea and the Railroad HQ. The Railroad HQ, I've never had the Fast Shadow, because I don't want to encounter two loading screens. One loading screen to go into the church, and one loading screen to go into their HQ. I did not want to deal with that. So I just fast travel. Also, the Glowing Sea, I mean, I don't want to go in there again. The only reason why I should be walking there is if I was in survival difficulty. Alright, so we're on our way to Tappeton Bowhouse, where we had to build a signal interceptor to get into the Institute. Hopefully, Tinker Tom can do his job. If he doesn't, I'll hold up my deliverer and go. I'll do that to him. That's right, I'll shoot him in the head. Alright, Gale Rhino's radioactive barrels. So that I don't die. I just take a moment to appreciate how much I made my character look like Joel. I mean, like I said, it's not a perfect match. It's not even a carbon copy. It's not even that great, but hey, it's pretty damn good, actually. If you compare both, it looked pretty similar. Almost kind of like a doppelganger. What was that? Hunter's dog. Okay, I don't want to mess with them. I mean, I doubt they'll do harm, but... So the Brotherhood are not my enemies. Then why the hell were they attacking me for? I'm not their enemy. They're not my enemy, so why the hell were they freaking attacking me when I was doing that mission? I don't know. Maybe it was because of the railroad mission. I don't know. All I know is Brotherhood can go fuck themselves. Oh, Greedy, watch out! Hey, I saved your ass, Greedy. Oh yeah, there are blood bugs here. Ugh. Ugh.
Now he's just starting to have fun.
Look, Creighton, you always have fun. Right, there's two more in this house. Okay.
That's how we do things around here.
Why didn't we come
up? Thanks
for Greedy. Alright, watch my bad webs while I'm off these.
Got it.
Okay. And do this one. Oh, did that all without breaking a body thing. No, I want to sit in the chair, damn it! No, I want to sit in the chair, get up. God damn it, I hate when that happens.
looks promising.
Hey, there's a weapon in here.
Really? Margaret's note. Mom, Russell has been gone for a day now and I'm getting worried. We were going to wait to tell you, but we found all the holiday from before the war in the boat shed. Sadly, someone has had some chems in the drain at the end of the canal. Russell thought we might be able to sell them to one of the traders. Maybe he's gonna buy another ramen. Sorry we didn't tell you. We just wanted to be surprised. But in a second, one of those bugs we've seen today, I think something went wrong. So I'm gonna have a look for him. Don't worry, I'm just gonna be getting back soon. Margie? Her name is Margie. Well, I know that I'm Mar. What is that nickname, but still. So, is it secure in a workshop? There we go. I guess I have a monitor, so that kind of slows us down a little bit. There we go. Alright, let's build this piece of shit. Yeah, I got something. There we go. Let's build right in the center of the road. Boom. I can hardly give a shit about commercial platforms or safe house. So right now, let's go back to Tinker Tom. I hate the fast travel, but yeah, let's do it. Alright, Tinker Tom, I'm back, you better. I built a platform for ya.
You got the platform built yet? Tick-tock. I'm waiting for the good news.
Yes, I built it.
I did it. The platform's constructed.
And I filled in the blanks on the blueprints. We can actually build this crazy thing. The science of this monstrosity is wild. But fortunate for us, the ingredients pretty common.
But there's three specialty items that I just can't grab from our safe houses.
You find those, and we'll knock down the gates of hell.
Like what?
I don't have time for a scavenger hunt.
There's only so far my miraculous ingenuity can go, my friend. I got needs.
Sensor module.
After you get the gettables, meet me at the build site.
Alright, let me see if I can build for now. I'm pretty sure I can build most of it. And plus, this episode, I want to get to the Institute. Hey, Des, what are you doing here? Alright, amen now, there you go. Special BS25, no, not the Brotherhood. Okay, I can build this. I can build this. Oh, I can build all of this. I can build all of it. Now I just gotta power it all up. 500 amps. Damn. We're gonna have this one. Oh, yes, I'm pretty much using mods, but it's worth it. Boom. I hate I had to do that, but hey, why not?
There's Demona.
Status report.
We got activity, Des.
Not sure how long before it peaks.
The Institute is a huge unknown. Before we can make any plans, you need to do something. What I'm about to tell you is the most closely guarded secret the railroad has. It's time you learn about Patriot.
The focus should be on the Institute, not this Patriot.
Just listen for a moment.
God damn it, Des.
There's a man, or woman, we're not sure, inside the Institute who helps synths escape.
I don't care!
Thousands of synths owe him their lives.
I don't care what the fuck has said.
We've never had a way to contact him, so we gave him the code name Patriot.
Why even join you assholes?
And you're able to get inside the Institute. We need you to make contact.
I won't risk my son.
I can't risk that. I need to find my son.
I'm confident you can find a way to do both.
Oh, fuck
leave
you.
It to your discretion. Tom,
yes, okay, wires me.
Patriot's eyes only. Once he sees it, he'll contact you. Until you make contact,
shut up.
Probably after, you need to stay in their good graces. You need to infiltrate them. Can you do that? Can you be our agent on the inside?
Fine.
Bring it on.
You can do this. I believe in you.
Why should I even do it?
I'll give you the holotape. Just plug it into any Institute terminal and wait for the reply.
Yeah, no, thank you.
You impressed yet? I told you
this frequency is only going to work once. You know who doesn't make the same mistake twice.
Agree, not yet. Once I get back. I hate to do this to Agree, but hey, I can't talk yet.
So stand still. You gotta lock in all those molecules of yours. Hopefully we won't miss any. There's only, you know, 60 trillion of them. All right, feeding our baby some juice. Let's see what she's got.
Take this holotape. You need it to contact Patriot.
Oh, man, don't worry. That's all part of the plan.
God damn it, Tom.
Do whatever you can to gain their trust. Lie. Tell them what they want to hear. Make up a cover story and sell it.
Come on.
I ain't losing your shit.
Establishing lock on the Institute signal.
Just get all the information you can. About synths.
I don't care about
the Institute's plans. Find their weaknesses. If we can disable or destroy the Institute, we may have to do it. You jack that holotape into any terminal, and Patriot will make contact. He has to.
Got the aura! We got it!
Find a way to save them. Nobody else can.
I don't care. I don't care about the synths. I don't care about the synths. I really don't. All I care about is my son, and I'm gonna find him. Oh, I'm not sweet. I also sneezed. Okay, what can I increase? Oh, okay, here's my lockpick. One more demolition or strong back. God damn, these are pretty fucking important. Oh, fuck, you're in vain. Damn it! It's either locksmith that was in this work or strong back. Actually, I need to do inspirational. Thank you. I think I have to do that network scanner thing. The holiday, right? Network scanner. Network scan. Download. Scan complete. Message from Tom. Begin. Peter's reply. That fast? Meet in the advance of the maintenance room.
Hello.
Hey.
I wondered if you might make it here. You're quite resourceful.
Where's my son, Aswells?
I'm known as Father. The Institute is under my guidance.
Really?
I know why you're here.
Yeah, for my
I'd
son!
I'd like to discuss things with you face to face. Step into the elevator.
Institutionalized.
I can only imagine what you've heard, what you think of us. I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression.
Really?
Welcome to the Institute.
Whoa, what the hell?
This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people.
Who built this?
The work we do. For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials.
God damn!
A shared vision of how science can help shape the future.
What the fuck?
It has never been easy. And our actions are often misinterpreted.
What I hear about you might be like hiding in a warehouse somewhere.
Someday, perhaps we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now,
it's supposed to take like hundreds of years to finish.
Underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all.
As I don't even believe this.
Above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason.
Yeah.
You are
Sean?
Here for your son.
Is that Sean? Yeah, Sean.
Sean?
Huh?
Sean!
Yes, I'm Sean.
Been looking for you, man.
Sean. I've been looking for you for so long.
Who are you?
I'm your dad.
Sean, it's me. I'm your dad.
Father, what's going on? What's happening?
Yes.
What's going on?
It's me.
Father?
Your dad.
Father!
I'm here, Sean.
Open the door.
Sean, open the door.
I don't know you. Go away.
What?
Father! Father, help me!
I'm your dad, damn it!
Here, help me!
Calm down!
Sean, please, calm down. I'll get you out of there.
Father? Father, help me! He's trying to take me!
Oh, you little brat.
Father, help me!
Oh, your father.
Sean. S923, recall code Cirrus.
What?
Fascinating.
He's a Sith?
The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew. I am Father. Welcome to the Institute.
Give me Sean.
Give me Sean. The real Sean. Right now!
I know. I know. You've gone to such lengths to find him.
Answers, asshole.
I want answers, asshole. Now.
Under the circumstances, I will forgive your vulgarity, but I need you realize
that this
situation is far more complicated than you could have imagined. You have traveled very far.
Why did he get cut off?
And suffered a great deal to find.
Probably an audio glitch.
Well, your tenacity and dedication have been rewarded. It's good to finally meet you after all this time.
What, you knew me or something?
It's me. I am Sean. I am.
What?
Your son.
What? How?
How is that even possible?
I know this is a lot to take in. In the vault, you had no concept of the passage of time. You were released from your pod and went searching for the sun you'd lost. But then you learned that your son
was... He kind of does blame me a little bit.
But a 10-year-old boy...
The muscular neck.
You believe...
The wrinkles.
10 years had passed. Is it really so hard to accept that it was not 10, but 60 years?
What?
That is the reality. And here I am. Raised by the Institute, and now its leader.
I guess that makes sense.
Hell of a story. But I guess... does make sense.
I'm glad you're willing to accept the truth. It's
on.
Encourage.
Damn, it is
though.
At
that time, the year 2227, the Institute had made great strides in synth production, but it was never enough.
What's the blood thinking?
Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever onward. What they wanted was the perfect machine. So they followed the best example thus far. The human being, walking, talking, fully articulate, capable of anything.
They needed specimens.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens. That's why they took you.
In a manner of speaking, yes. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical starting point, of course, was human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course, but it had all become corrupted. In this wasteland, radiation affected everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. Another source.
So that's why it took Sean. But they killed my wife!
After discovering records from Vault 111. Frozen in time, protected from the radiation-induced mutations that had crept into every other human cell in the Commonwealth. I was exactly what they needed. And so it was my DNA that became the basis of the synthetic organics used to create every human-like synth you see today. I am their father. Through science, we are family. The synths, me, and you.
Damn, it's really you, man.
Sean. It's really you.
It really is. I know you must have questions. Please. Anything I can do to help you understand.
Oh. The Institute, your mother, and Kel. Wait, hold on. I gotta close my door. The Institute.
So you're in charge of the Institute?
I am the acting director here. I spent decades working to reach this point. It's a responsibility I take very seriously. The Institute. It's important. It really is humanity's best hope for the future, no matter what those above ground might think of us.
It doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter what they think. What matters is what you do.
I'm glad we see it the same way. Ultimately, the Commonwealth has nothing to fear from us. Whatever you've seen or heard, I know I can convince you of that. Just give me time. What else can I say to ease your mind?
Your mother.
Your mother. She never got to see
you. I'm gonna ask all of it.
Yes. What happened to her was... I've gone over the records of the incident, of course. It seems her death was an unfortunate bit of collateral damage.
Collateral damage? What?
Collateral damage? Is that all she was to you?
I forget that it's been such a short time for you. I don't have any direct memories.
My charisma is pretty high.
And I've had my entire life to cope with a loss. Has it always been easy? Of course not. But I've done my best to move on and live my life. For many years, I never questioned who my parents were. I accepted my situation, and that was that.
Who is this voice that takes? Sounds familiar.
And asking what if more often. But what matters now is that you
it sounds familiar, I swear to God.
To begin again. What else can I say to ease your mind?
Kellogg. Kellogg's Captain Crunch.
Kellogg? He worked for you?
Kellogg. He was an Institute asset long before I arrived here. It wasn't until I became director that I learned of all the things he'd done. What kind of man he was.
Murderer.
He was a murderer. He killed your mother.
Believe me. I am well aware of the atrocities Kellogg committed. I suspect there are many more we'll never know of. The Institute took advantage of Kellogg's vicious nature. I will freely admit that. Institute technology prolonged his life and
I'm gonna look at the words after.
His usefulness far beyond any normal human lifespan. He never failed the Institute. But his cruelty became more apparent
Ooh.
With every completed objective.
Legends of the Breath of the Wild, only game of the year.
It's no coincidence your path crossed his. It seemed a fitting way to allow you, us, to have some amount of revenge. I know there's more for us to discuss, but the Institute is on the verge of some important breakthroughs. Your presence would be appreciated as we approach them. I've been a part of something amazing here. I've helped to build a life for myself and the people of the Institute. And now, after all these years, you have an opportunity to help with that. Doesn't that intrigue you? Isn't that what you want?
Wait, what? Stay here?
You want me to stay here? In the Institute?
Yes. That is what I propose. Is it so hard to imagine?
Tony Amendola.
The can provide a better life than anything above ground.
Tony Amendola, that's his name.
The Commonwealth. You've seen what it's like. I assure you,
he's still alive.
Better off with us.
Wait, he was in Annabelle. Shame. He wasn't in Mask of Zorro? Huh. Yes, I'll stay here.
Things are pretty terrible up there. I've seen it myself.
He was in Stargate. SG-1.
We are so committed to creating a better life for ourselves here. And it's a life that you can now be part of. I simply ask that you give the Institute, me, a chance. A chance to show you what I've been telling you. We really do have humanity's best interest at heart. Will you take that chance?
Yes.
All right.
Thank you. The Institute is now your home, as much as it is mine. Please take some time, get to know it. Meet the people you'll be working with. You'll want to introduce yourself to the division heads. Dr. Fillmore in Facilities. Dr. Ayo in SRB. Dr. Holdren in Bioscience. And finally, Dr. Lee in Advanced Systems. They've all been notified of your arrival, of course. Meet them. And then we'll discuss what...
Hello, Tony Amendola. Meet the division leaders. God damn. So, Sean's 60 years old. Well, yeah, sissies. Yep, the Institute is not my home. Fuck everyone else.
Almost done. Just
wait, got it. This one.
Tighten up this primary drive servo.
That's the third primary drive breakdown this month. As far as I'm concerned, the phase out on these older models can't come soon enough.
Oh, I don't know. Most of them have lasted long past their projected lifespan.
That's a nice tool set.
If you ask me, they were built pretty well.
I can't argue with that.
Jesus Christ.
Even so, I'm ready to see the full Gen 3 roll out.
There we go. All set. Unit, you can return to duty.
I said thank you, ma'am, but I don't know if I'm getting here.
Of course.
Our technology must seem pretty advanced by your standards.
We're all looking forward to working with you.
They weren't kidding. You really are here. Well, all right. I'm Allie. Allie Fillmore. You can think of me as the Institute's chief engineer. When
really?
Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much, I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
Find my son.
I just wanted to find my son and keep him safe.
Now that you've found him, I hope you're proud of the great man he grew up to be. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and then I'll answer any questions you might have afterward. As you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
Yep.
Absolutely.
Oh, good to hear. It'll be a load off Sean's mind. Take your time. Get yourself acquainted. There's a lot to take in. Plenty of things you won't find topside. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the facilities division, I'm happy to discuss it.
Who built all this?
Who built this place originally? Has it been here long?
The construction of the Institute is the work of generations of scientists. The original survivors of the war, our progenitors, took refuge in the basement of the old Commonwealth Institute of Technology. Over time, their sons and daughters dug deeper into the earth and built increasingly sophisticated habitats and laboratories. It's a process that's still going on today. Even now, we're digging out tunnels for new facilities and infrastructure. Just think what this place will look like 100 years from now. I hope I'm there to see it.
100 years? I think you'd be dead, lady. Because you're pretty old now.
It's an honor to have you here, sir.
You know the protocol, sir.
Which one? Synth retention.
So Dr. Ayo thinks he can hide in his office, does he? Well, you can tell him that I intend to speak to Father about these unannounced...
Can do it? Oh, Newton Overly.
All systems nominal. Heading over to robotics to knock some heads together.
What now?
Report anything suspicious.
Shut up.
They heard we lost another Gen 3. Dr. Ayo was furious.
Please don't.
No, that courser? That was me.
There's enough friction as it is between us and pretty much all the other departments.
You going soft on me, Alana? My methods get results, and they will this time as well. You'll see.
Hi, Doc.
So, here you are.
Here I am.
Fineo, acting director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
I guess we'll see.
I guess we'll find out.
Indeed. Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview of the Synth Retention. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped Synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
Secret police?
So basically, you're the secret police.
Secret police? If that's a pre-war reference, then I'm afraid it's lost on me.
Men in Black?
Our main instrument is the Courser, a third-generation Synth assigned to operate on the surface. Coursers hunt down and reclaim Synths that have escaped the Institute. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. In a word, our Coursers are relentless. But I gather you know all this, since you've encountered them. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
I killed it in one shot. It was useless.
I hate to break it to you, but your Courser wasn't all that tough.
Then it's likely the unit was defective.
I killed it in one shot.
I suppose I'll have to ask robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production line. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get back to work.
Oh, shit. Hey, Courser training. What's that like?
You mentioned that Coursers undergo special training. Tell me more about it.
The SRB constantly monitors the gender-free synth population, looking for specific traits. Those who show tenacity, fearlessness, and independence undergo a rigorous training regimen. We teach them armed and unarmed combat, investigative techniques, psychology, and mechanical skills. Those who pass a final evaluation become Coursers. The rest have their memories wiped and return to their former duties.
Oh, nice. So only a few can become Coursers. I see. So I got what, two more divisions to check out?
No visible reaction on the K-14 compound.
This place is huge though. How do they build this shit? Advanced systems. Oh, Clay's knocking on my door. Boom. Hey Cody.
She's been at it for over 2 hours. What is she even testing?
Nothing. At this point, she's just doing it for fun.
Stop asking me.
Excuse me, doctor?
Ah, it's you. You're here then. Yes,
here.
I know who you are. We all do. While I'm sure Father is very happy that you're here, I do hope it doesn't interrupt our work.
What work?
What is it you're working on?
Advanced systems, special projects. You've seen the boy, Synth, already. We've been hard at work on him for quite a while now. Oh, before I forget, let me see that Pip-Boy of yours. I've been told to install a Courser chip in it for you. Father's orders. You're to be given full access, with the ability to relay in and out of the Institute at will.
Oh, hell yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm sure that'll come in handy.
Given that the relay is the only way to access the Institute, handy is something of an understatement.
I bet.
In case the significance is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind of access. If nothing else, it should demonstrate the amount of trust Father has placed in you. Now, unless there's something else, I really do need to get back to work.
What about the division?
Tell me about the people in your division.
I'm not sure what there is to say. Dr. Watson is the Specialist Project's lead scientist. He's, very organized and precise. Dr. Ormond is one of the youngest scientists in the Institute, and she's something of a prodigy when it comes to physics.
Really? That's it? What do you guys do? Oh, did they make guns, I guess? They made the weapons?
One day, I'll design a more efficient reactor to replace that old clunker in the basement.
Excuse me, Doctor.
Hmm? Oh, hi there. Sorry if I seem distracted. I memorized 5 sets of
the last thought there was.
I'm doing detailed mental comparisons.
You're lying.
Come on, don't bullshit me.
I didn't say it was easy. But I've been practicing at it since I was a little girl.
Anyway, I'm glad you're here. I just wanted to say how much I admire Father, and that it's an honor to meet you. I really hope you'll stay here with us.
And I am. Thank you, thank you, thank you. What's in here? Oh, shit, I didn't mean to draw this. And... there you go. Anyway. On to, what was it on? Bioscience? What the hell is it called? Bioscience, yeah, it was. That the Virgil was from it, too. Oh, so this is where I can find this cure. Whoa. Damn. This is pretty... is that a gorilla?
Dr. Holdren's synth gorilla project is showing promising
results. Oh, but I ain't real? I ain't real gorilla. Oh, man, they're pretty damn close. I mean, they're pretty damn close.
I try not to think too much about it. We have more than enough monkeys.
Doctor,
there's still people. And it's good to have you. Dr. Clayton Holdren, head of the Bioscience Division. After all, I can't wait for you to see the work we're doing. It's truly amazing.
We'll see.
I'll reserve judgment until I know more about it.
In that case, let me give you a brief overview of what we do here. As the name implies, the Bioscience Division specializes in fields of study such as botany, genetics, and medicine. Our most important directive is to ensure the health and well-being of everyone in the Institute. To that end, we cultivate highly specialized breeds of flora for use in food and medicine. We've even started to explore the idea of synthetic animal life. You probably saw the gorillas. They're really just a pet project at this point, but the potential is exciting nonetheless.
Yeah, I can't imagine anything more exciting than fake gorillas.
Speaking only for myself, I find it fascinating.
I love sarcastic options.
Of course, I might be a little biased. I'm sure I've taken up enough of your time as it is. But I have to ask, have you decided whether you'll join us?
I'd like to.
I'm not sure how well I'll fit in, but I'd like to give it a try.
Great. I was hoping you'd say that. In any case, I imagine you'll want to continue looking around. Or, if you prefer, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have.
Yeah, I'm okay. No, I'm good for now.
I'm good for now.
I can now fash out two from the Institute. Hell yeah.
Most men lack the patience to observe and document plant growth.
Yeah, okay. So, but I need to find out the Virgil's cure. It's probably in the back somewhere. Because it said old office. Synth retention, taught the father. Ooh, synthetic, thank you. Another here, synthetic. Thank you. Is it in here? What the hell is Calmex? I know it's a drug. Plus 2 times sneak attack multiplier. Also plus 3 perception and plus 3 agility. Damn, pretty good. But I'll use chems. So this is not it. So like in here or somewhere? Warwick Homestead Initiative. That's on it. This feels like a damn maze. In here. Hi, Nora. Where is it? Where's Virgil's old lab? How big is this place? No, it's not that way. Ooh, thank you. Unlock. Fuck, buy a pin. I have a lot of buy pins.
Yes.
Ooh. Stim pack, stuff your fire water, and that's it. FEV lab, here we go. So it should be in here.
Sweet.
Okay. Oh, that's a laser. too quiet in here. I don't like it. I want whopping.
Nice.
Nothing in here. Oh, wait. Nope, it's not all. Didn't make it. Oh, shit! Where's MacReady when you need him? There's an assault rifle here! Oh no. I need my shotgun. There's an assault rifle here. I don't like that.
Resetting threat level.
Let's quick save. Well, okay, I gotta get a lot of this.
Sweet.
Perimeter contact.
What? Oh, thank God. Hey, what the hell? Why am I like black? Wrong in the, wait. There we go. And boom. And boom. Thank you. Can I get him over this? Huh.
Terminal's got this locked.
Oh, I have to hack. Okay, here we go. Like, what is the two? L-I-K-E, 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 L-I-K-E. Take. Nope, that's one. Like, going side.
There we go.
Any more surprises for me? Whoa. Oh, yep, this must be his old lab. Where is it? Nope, not here. Nope. Is that it? Nope, that's a drinking glass. God damn it. Here it is. So, bring us here to Virgil.
Please resist any urge you might feel to eat the specimens on the hydroponic garden.
Alright. Oh yeah, I think it's not the father, right? Well, I'm on my way. Son. Yeah, you know what? Fuck the memo. I'm not gonna be with him anymore.
Sean,
now that you've had a chance to see the Institute firsthand, what do you think?
It's amazing.
You've got technology here that I never dreamed possible. It's amazing.
I'm glad you can appreciate what we've accomplished. None of
Cody.
Ultimately, all our knowledge and resources are focused on a single goal. The goal is best summarized by our motto: mankind redefined. Unfortunately, no advancement comes without occasional setbacks. As remarkable as our synths are, they can be dangerous without proper supervision. The superior synth mind and body attempting to wrestle with something approaching free will can be a recipe for chaos.
What do you mean by proper supervision?
I mean that while they are here in the Institute, fulfilling the purpose for which they were designed, our synths perform admirably. As you're about to see, however, they can become unpredictable when set loose. A rogue synth has taken over the Raider gang at Libertalia. His memories have been erased, and his identity altered. He believes he's a man named Gabriel. Under his leadership, the Raiders have taken many innocent lives. I've dispatched a courser.
Sean looks like, I'd like you he's done with life. Reclaim this. Why don't I just kill it?
It might not want to talk. It would be safer just to kill it.
That would be a terrible waste of a valuable resource. If at all possible, that synth should be returned alive. Now you should get moving. Many people are in danger, and a delay could cost lives.
Alright, that sounds wonderful, Sean, but I'll have to wait for the next episode. Hope you guys enjoyed in this very weird and twisty episode of Fallout 4, and please stay tuned for more. Later!